All right. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Heroes of the Pacific. I am your pilot for today, Jaeger Bishop. Today, torpedo lessons. Something tells me this is not going to be your average torpedo lesson. Well, torpedo bombing lesson, but you understand what I'm saying. So, without further ado, let's get to it, shall we?
Accurate torpedo bombing is vital to our war effort. So today we need you to fly a training mission with Lieutenant Commander Callahan so he can show you the ropes. He'll be using live torpedoes against a wrecked transport that was hit by a Japanese bomber several days ago. It's dead in the water but still floating, so at least you can get some target practice in when we scuttle it.
Hit them where it hurts. Yeah, the torpedo bombers usually do. Let's see. Well, there are no ways to upgrade this thing, so let's do this. Me personally, I would like to pilot the Avenger instead, but oh well. Workshop. Grounding 50 cal, so we're gonna go for tight and straight, so let's do this. It's only got a couple of 50 cals. Ooh, bow of the Coral Sea, that's not a good one. Americans actually lost that battle. Well, strategically anyway. Now the shipwreck actually isn't moving, so there's no need to lead the target, but normally you have to give a bit of lead. And goodbye. I know this may not look, so exciting compared to fighter combat, but I'm gonna be real with you here. Devastator pilots were freaking just God. Some of the things they had to go through.
Lexington, this is Fox 1. The Japs have sent a squadron of subs to repair the damaged one.
You, go away! Come on, go away. Thank you. I mean, imagine having... I mean, imagine for a second you have to... There are only few I-400s actually ever built.
I can't believe
that sub's launching fighters. I'll take care of
the plane. You concentrate on sinking that sub.
Alright, let's get in range. Whoops! That wasn't supposed to happen. Okay. Yeah. Whoopsie. Okay, that was the button I meant to hit. Okay. I'm not sure if that's actually gonna hit, but... No. Not enough leeway. Come on. Please. Alright. Alright, let's go away before we get that thing's AA gun attention. Yes! Ha ha! Alright. We're gonna just hover out here outside of gun range until we get... Yep, there we go. Alright. And... There we go. Come on! Alright, come on. Nice. Let's try and line this up. And very good. And we peel off again. Man. This thing can take a pounding. Come on. Wow, I actually hit it at that angle. little bit close. Well, a lot closer than I would like, but... Yep, let's just not get that close, thank you. Man, I keep hitting that thing, but it just does not want to die. Yes, come on. And come on. Yes. Yeah, I wouldn't try loop-de-loops in that thing if I were you. I love how they do this little thing. Ooh, the SPD2 Dauntless. Ooh, oh boy. Dauntless dive bombers. Oh, and the A6M2 and roof. Kill 6. I think you have to play on higher difficulties in order to unlock the Avenger. But, oh well.
The Japanese are tightening their hold on the Solomon Islands to prevent any future Allied counterattacks. If they get a stronger foothold in the area, it will allow them to attack Northern Australia. Through the Kobe radio intercepts, we have learned that the heavy carriers, the Shokaku and the Zukaku, both veterans of Pearl Harbor, are here in the Coral Sea. They are accompanied by the Shoho, a smaller carrier. Our scouts have spotted the Shoho. You are to attack her immediately. Other wings will deal with the other threats.
All right. Let's see, SPD Dauntless. Well, I have 2 points, so let's go for it. Ooh. I could have used the extra agility. Well, phooey for you, I guess. 2 1,000-pound bombs. Ish. Man. I almost regret not playing this on a higher difficulty now. Oh well. We'll make do with what we have. Tight. 1,000-pound love letter right through that deck should do it.
Cats are hungry, and I'm looking forward to getting a few kills on the bullet myself.
dog, Wayne. Just don't get shot down again, Tom. We're not coming to pick you up next time.
Shot down? Actually, I'll ram the minute. I'll tell you about it tonight. But you are behind the drinks. Follow me, man.
Here we go. Shot after my relocation. Ah, gotcha. I do not like any of you. Go away. All right. Let's get up. Let's get high and into the clouds. Help here. Rest in pieces.
Ship is burned.
Scratch one flat top.
Good work, man. Charlie and Don waked up the Shoho. We damaged the Chicago pretty heavily. Time to head back to the carrier.
Wow, can't believe I actually pulled that off. My plane's smoking a bit. You go away. All right, I don't like you, so you gotta. Took him down, but I guess it didn't credit with any of the kill, whatever. Okay. Okay, this is officially not good. Ow. Okay, this has officially gotten stupid. No kidding.
Bomber's targeted. Moving to engage. Bomber, going now.
Did I not just say go away? Thank you. Hey, you leave that carrier alone.
Attack my target.
Confirm. Bombers are my target.
Confirm kill.
Bomber down.
Sorry. No trespassers. No. I thought he was gonna ram me for a second. Oh, jeez. Bugger off. Buzz off, will ya? It's like my tail gunner's just trying. How many of you blasted? All victories, eh? PBY5 Catalina. Oh, joy.
The rest of the squadron had already started celebrations when I landed. We finally managed to hit back at the Japs, and the Shaw was well on its way to the bottom of the Pacific. Later, Callahan and I headed down to the hangar deck to check the damage to our planes. We heard a noise and someone ran off. We didn't catch him, but we found a chunk of metal wedged in the ammo tray of my Corsair. We'd surprise some bastard who tried to sabotage my plane. Callahan and I decided not to tell anyone. We didn't want the other pilots to panic. After that, I personally checked every inch of my plane before every mission.
Well, you should, just out of habit.
It was the first ever battle between ships that never even saw each other. Just hundreds of planes attacking each other and the carriers on the other side. The Japs did more damage to us than we did within the core. They sank the Lexington and one of their destroyers. But we did manage to sink one of their carriers and damage another, the Shikoku. Even though we lost the battle strategically, we kind of won. First, we stopped the Jeff advance. Second, and more importantly, we took out two of their carriers to play battles. Back in the U.S., our intelligence operation codenamed Magic was decoding Japanese communications. Magic discovered Japanese plans for another surprise attack, this time against Midway. The Japs made it look like they were attacking the Aleutian Islands up in Alaska, so that we would send part of our fleet away from Midway. But we knew what they were up to. We weren't about to get caught off. suit the city.
Specifically, actually, how they did that was they sent false transmissions saying, you know, Midway is low on water. And because of the fact that what the Codebreakers had surmised was there was a designation AF, right? So what happened was the Americans found this in their code. It was like, well, what's AF? So they decided, well, we'll send a false transmission, you know, saying, because they suspected at this point that it might be Midway, so they said Midway was low on water. And sure enough, the next transmission they intercepted was AF is low on water. So, aha! That's where they're going to strike next, because there was a planned attack against a target called AF. So, that's how they knew. Anyway, that Midway Patrol, that will be next time. As usual, I've been your Bishop, and I thank you all for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I will see you all next time. Take care, everybody.